Hello everybody, this is Zohir Choudhury. Today we'll talk about landfill. So what are the components of solid waste stream? We had introduced earlier some of the specific components of solid waste stream. In here, we can see the solid waste in percent volume. So 50% of the solid waste is typically, by volume, is typically paper, followed by miscellaneous components as well as organic component and plastic and metals and glass. So this is by volume. If we look at by weight or by mass, we can see that for the year 2013, prior to recycling, this is the distribution of the various component of solid waste. Again, almost one third is paper. And almost one third is food and trimmings, with the other materials in here, for a total of 254 million tons before recycling. After recycling, the amount is reduced to 167 million tons, recycling and composting. But still, in this 167 million tons, we can still see a lot of materials such as paper and paperboard, air trimmings, metals, plastics, wood, food products that potentially could be recycled that actually is going into the landfill. So the things that can be recycled in here is paper, glass, metals, and plastics. They're all recyclable. Food waste and yard trimmings, they are compostable. And the non-recyclable and non-compostable components are typically rubber, leather, and textile, which are in here. So this is the component that would eventually go to the landfill, and everything else should not go to the landfill moving into the future. So a strategy for proper waste management would definitely be to figure out a way to be able to recapture all of this waste product that are either recyclable or compostable in some manner, so it's usable, trying to minimize as much as possible the usage of rubber, leather, and textile that are not recyclable, and finding ways and opportunities to be able to minimize the usage, or finding alternative products for meeting the purpose of those of things to lead a sustainable life. Landfill has a lot of problems. In here, in this picture, you can see this gooey substance, which is known as a leachate. What is a leachate? Leachate generally is generated from landfill sites and contains toxic heavy metals such as lead, typically coming from batteries, cadmium, arsenic, nickel, as well as solvents and cleaning agents. All of these chemicals there are typically part of the waste because of the things that we throw in the landfill. And when rain falls, the rain dissolves all of these chemicals from the waste and percolates through the landfill and goes into the bottom of the landfill. Or if the landfill is not properly lined, can actually scatter around in areas nearby, contaminating the soil and also the groundwater. Landfill can also emit air pollution. The major gas of concern is methane, beside carbon dioxide, of course, but methane. And methane is coming because of anaerobic decomposition of the waste. Also, volatile organic compounds are emitted from landfills, which causes odor issues. Methane is very combustible, so it's a fire hazard and also a very potent greenhouse gas. And the VOCs cause a respiratory irritation to people that are living nearby. Costs of landfill operation are rising. Transportation costs to the landfill are also rising. Landfills are typically located further and further away from the main city, which adds to the transportation cost. And because of all the laws and regulations that are associated with waste disposal, running and monitoring landfill also is becoming an increasing burden and expense. Plus, there are some legal liabilities as well. Talking about how to build landfill. The liner system of a landfill is extremely important. The landfill are lined, as you can see on the bottom, with multiple layer system, typically this will prevent the waste from migrating downward, as well as the leachate. The leachate, as it migrates in here, gets captured in this pipe system, which there's some pump that causes pumps the leachate liquid up, and it's further processed and stored in a disposed of in a hazardous waste landfill. The top of the landfill is covered with earth and vegetation once it's all completed, and also there's a gas venting system to release the methane gas that gets produced from the anaerobic decomposition of the waste inside the landfill. Here you can see another diagram showing the landfill, the lining system, the methane vent, as well as the leachate disposal system and the cleanup system. On the bottom, you can see groundwater and a monitoring well that is also required. The monitoring well helps to continuously monitor the groundwater below the landfill to see whether there's been some penetration of the leachate into the groundwater system. As soon as you notice chemicals coming leaching from the landfill, you can figure out a way to quickly clean up the water or finding ways to intervene before the problem gets magnified. The leachate collection system of course has to be treated, and the gas collection system can be used to generate electricity because methane gas from landfill is a natural gas and can be used to produce electricity. This man is showing the leachate on this arm, and on that side is showing a cleanup process that cleans up the leachate. So the design of landfills is extremely important, and in here you can read what we mentioned about the membrane system and finding the proper geologic site to locate the landfill, the leachate collection system, as well as anaerobic decomposition of bacteria and the specific issues that can arise from landfill being improperly designed. And this video is a short video that will also be posted with your material. You can click in here, but also check your website for more for the direct link. In San Diego County, this is where I live, you can find three major landfills: the Miramar landfill, the Sycamore Canyon landfill, and the Otay Mesa landfill. And this is a picture of the Sycamore Canyon landfill. Let's do a quick concept check. Which of the following waste material or material make up most of the landfill by volume? Exactly, paper. It's the largest one. Whereas plastic bottle, glass, food waste, individually, they're less than the paper. Good job. Thank you, and we'll talk.